Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be continuing on with my travel to Japan series, and today I'm going to do one of my most requested videos, what to pack to Japan. So I've traveled to Japan a couple of times and I'm going to tell you guys what I pack in my suitcase when I go to Japan. So the first thing that's the most important to me is my electronics. I always bring my laptop, my cameras, my phone when I go to Japan. And the problem is that I'm from Australia and the PowerPoints from Japan and Australia are very different, so you'll need an adapter. And I think if you live in the US, you may not need an adapter because this is the same, I think. When I went to the US, I used this Japanese adapter over there and that worked fine. But anyway, if you need one of these, you can pick these up in any of the electronic stores in your own country. For example, in Australia, just go to Dick Smith's, JB Hi-Fi, travel stores, they should have them for only about $10 or so. And if you forget to bring one, it's fine, you can buy one in Japan as well. I actually bought this one in Japan because I lost the one I bought somewhere. So I went to Big Camera and brought one of these there. You can also buy them in any of the big electronic stores in Japan, they're hard to miss. Also, this is optional, but because I always bring a lot of electronics with me, like my laptop, cameras, phones and stuff, and I need to charge them every day, I recommend bringing a power board with you. So usually when I go to Japan, I bring a power board for all my Australian electronics and a adapter. So, you know, just plug it in, plug this into the wall, charge all my stuff in here so I don't have to buy more adapters. Also for Australians, your electronics may not work in Japan because we use 240 volts. I know most places in the world use 110 volts. So most of my electronics have worked fine. Most of them are dual voltage anyway. So that is probably the first thing I pack, my electronics, all my chargers and everything. They're very important for me when I travel. Another thing you should think about packing is if you're staying in hostels, then you need to bring your own towels along with you. Usually they don't provide you towels, and if they do, then they'll charge you for it. So I just rather bring my own towel. Also, I like to bring my own toothbrushes, toothpaste, shampoo and all that stuff. I know that most hostels and most hotels provide them, but I don't like the ones that they provide, so I just rather bring my own. So I pack all those into a little toiletry bag. In terms of clothes, when I go to Japan, I pretty much don't pack any clothes with me. I maybe might pack one set of clothing to wear, but I like to buy everything there. And I know if I pack a lot of clothes, then my suitcase is going to be full and I'll be buying a lot over there. If I buy a lot, then my luggage is going to end up being overweight. So I usually pack just one change of clothes and then go shopping straight away once I'm in Japan. And now for those of you who are traveling to Japan in the upcoming winter, I'm going to give you guys a few tips on how to keep warm during winter and what to pack. So I've traveled to Japan 3 times during winter, so this is from my own experience. In a few of my winter outfit videos, people have asked me how I can wear shorts and skirts during winter. Well, the thing is, a lot of girls actually do wear shorts and skirts during winter in Japan, and that's pretty much how I started wearing shorts and skirts during winter. It's really not that bad if you wear thermals or use some of the heat packs. So for example, I don't know if most countries do sell thermal stuff or not, because in Australia, it's not that cold in Australia during winter, so we don't really have thermals. But usually I just pack like a pair of leggings with me. These are thermal leggings that I got in Japan, Heattech from Uniqlo. With these ones, they only cost about $10 and you can buy them in any Uniqlo store. And these stores are like everywhere in Japan, so I'm sure that you'll be able to find one. You might be able to find them in the US stores as well, I'm not too sure. Also with thermals, you can also buy some from Liz Lisa. So this is a camisole I got from Liz Lisa last year. And this one was about 20 bucks. So these go on sale when you go to Japan mid-January. So if you want to just buy them in Japan, then just buy them there. But if you can buy them in your own country, then bring those along, because thermals will really help keep you warm during the winter. And also, this is probably something that you buy in Japan, not when you're at home, but I'm going to show you guys anyway, because since I'm on topic about keeping warm in Japan. When I'm in Japan, I always buy these heat packs, and you can buy these anywhere, in like any pharmacy, any supermarket, convenience store, and they're really cheap. And so pretty much these are heat packs, and you stick these behind your clothing, so it just traps the heat and it keeps you really warm. And these heat up a lot, so I don't know how hot they heat up to, but it does heat up quite a lot and it keeps you really warm during winter. I like to buy the little small ones like these, and then I like to stick two onto the back of my camisoles, and it just keeps me so warm during winter. And that's pretty much how I can survive wearing skirts and shorts in Japan. So if you're a person that can't really take the cold weather well, then I strongly recommend you get these. These are super cheap. I think I bought 30 of these for only about $5. So definitely recommend them. And also, if you are traveling winter and get sick easily from the cold, I strongly recommend you bring your own medicine along with you. I got sick once in Japan and I bought Japanese medicine. To be honest, it didn't do anything to me. I don't think Japanese medicine is that strong, so I strongly recommend you bring your own medicine from your own country. And now money. You need money to go to Japan, obviously. And there's a few ways of what you can do in terms of money. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is cash. So Japan is still like a cash society. They use cash for most things. They're slowly bringing credit cards in now, but it's not like in the States or Australia. Now, from personal experience, if you're going to use cash, exchange cash in your own country before going to Japan. I don't know if it's the same for most countries, but I realized that exchanging Japanese yen in my country, I get a much better rate. A couple of times in Japan, I have run out of cash before and I had no choice but to exchange cash in Japan. The exchange rates were horrible and it's also really hard finding a place to exchange cash. I usually go to a Travelex in Japan and yeah, the rates are just really bad. If you want to, you can exchange cash at airports, but I don't recommend it as well because the exchange rates are always horrible. So usually with me, I exchange my cash before I go to Japan. I just go to the city and go to like a flight center or any of the exchange currency centers, and the rates are much better than in Japan and airports. And now I'm just going to talk a bit about travel cards. So depending on your bank, they might offer you travel cards, and I've used travel cards before. It's quite simple and easy. You can use it to withdraw out of ATMs. Fees depends on the bank you're with. So I was with Commonwealth and I had a travel card that I used in Japan, and I remembered every time I withdrew money, it cost me I think 300 yen, so about $5 to withdraw. So if I do withdraw from it, I withdraw as much money as I can in one go. But also the exchange rate wasn't great on that card, so I stopped using it. And if you guys are into using credit cards, in Japan now, most stores do accept credit cards. There's a few small ones like restaurants and that don't take them, but most stores do now. What I personally like doing is that I like to bring a credit card along with me, and if I need cash, I just withdraw from the credit card at any post office or 7-Eleven. Most of these ATMs do have English options as well, if that makes things a lot easier for you. So in terms of credit card, I use a 28 Degrees card, and I don't know if this is international or not, or if it's just for Australians. It's great because there's no international fees when you go shopping, when you withdraw money. The ATM might charge you fees, but the card doesn't. And then also the best thing about the card is that the exchange rate you get on the card is pretty much the current exchange rate, which is great. I've had it for about a year now. It works great in Japan and it's pretty easy to get if you have a job as well. So just apply for it if you want to have a card that doesn't charge you any international fees or anything like that. And of course you need obvious things like your passport when going to Japan, you know, clean underwear every day. And I don't know if there's anything else you need to bring to Japan. Usually when I go to Japan, my big suitcase is about 6 kilos or something like that. I don't put anything in there at all. So if you are like me and like to shop, then go empty to Japan. Just bring like the most important things like your electronics, money, etc. And yeah, just go nuts in Japan. If your bag is overweight and you have too much luggage that you can't put into your bags, then you can have an option of shipping it back to your own country. So if your bag is overweight and you've got too much luggage, that is an option that you can do, because I believe if you pay for the extra fees if your bag is overweight, it's pretty expensive. But other than that, hopefully this video was helpful and hope you guys all have a fun trip to Japan. And if you guys have any more questions about what you want me to talk about in terms of traveling to Japan, then please let me know in the comment box below or email me at kimdaoquestions@gmail.com, and I try my best to answer as many questions as I can regarding traveling to Japan in these videos in the future. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.